for a minute. Totally lost here. Oh, it's been a long 2 weeks since we've been on the air, and we have no band today. We have lights, but we do have guests. We have a couple of comedians here today, so I hope you're going to enjoy them. It's all about a show that's going on next Tuesday night at Caroline's. We'll get into that a little bit later, but just to open up the show with a little serious note. A week ago Monday was Memorial Day, or the celebration of Memorial Day. Today is the 54th anniversary of D-Day, so just for all the people out there who have had relatives who served in World War II or anything like that, these are people that should be remembered. They did a lot of service for this country, and we here at Welcome Aboard did want to spend a little time remembering them today. Stick around, we're going to be right back with Tommy Savitt and some more fun. Don't go anywhere. Once again, live on a Tuesday, the only live show in Brooklyn right here on BCAT. If you want to join in the fun and become a BCAT producer, call 718-935-1122. There goes our public service announcement. Enough of that. Next week, we're going to have Gandalf Murphy and the Slobovian Circus of Dreams. I have no idea who this guy is. You ever heard of Gandalf Murphy? You're the musician.
No.
You don't know Gandalf, okay. And then the following week after that, on June the 20th, we're going to have Rhonda Schuster is going to be here and play some music for us then. But today, we have a lone person clapping in the audience here. I have a gentleman here who's been on the show previously, and he's got some serious beefs with what's going on. Tom, I mean, we had a little discussion. This is Tom Savitt, by the way. What would you call a producer or... With blue collar.
All right, let's get it straight. I'm not a comedian.
Oh, you're not.
I'm not a comedian.
Okay.
I talk to the people. Next June 13th, which is next week, Tuesday, 9:30 in the evening.
Uh huh.
Basically, we're gonna start with the comedy world, and then we're gonna revolt against the government.
Uh huh.
Basically, what's going on in the comedy scene is you have these club owners.
Right.
Who are working in conjunction with the government, preventing from the new comics, the new comedians, to express their ideas. So thus, you have the old talent that are hogging up the pavement for the younger comics to break through.
Like the David Brenners.
Correct. They're done. It's over for them. You see? Now, June 13th, if you're a wrestling fan and you like violence and you like comedy, this is the place to be.
Caroline's.
We're going to take over. All the old comics are going to get their head smashed in, and you're going to have the new breed performing live. Various top talented new performers that you don't get to see because the old timers are taking up the stage. Their days are done. It's done. Just like the government is done.
Done, huh?
Done. Exactly.
Amazing. Right. 9:30 next Tuesday to June,
exactly.
June 13th.
So we start, like, because the comedy scene is a microcosm of the macrocosm.
Right.
Okay. So, basically, I'm going to do a lot of damage that night.
You're going to do a lot of damage?
There's going to be a lot.
Tables, chairs.
There's going to be, there's going to be body bags.
Uh-huh.
There's going to be midgets. There's going to be ladies from Hooters escorting the new breeds up on stage. And the old timers that happen to be on that show, watch out, and they know who they are.
And what made you decide that all of a sudden these old timers are just, you know, had too much of it? I mean, have they?
It's done. The comedy scene sucks the way it is.
Is this all behind? This is all behind the scenes stuff. This is the stuff that people don't see on the
stage. And I'm going to expose them, just like I'm going to expose the government, one step at a time, okay? And I'll tell you this. I, in this country, you have no freedom to choose. I went down to the deli, okay, outside there, and if you don't believe me that you don't have a freedom of choice here, try to order a breakfast special after 11. Okay? Doesn't happen, does it? Can't make this stuff up.
Especially McDonald's.
No. So basically, exactly.
Have you ever gone into McDonald's and asked for breakfast at like 11:15?
They don't give it to you. You can't get anything. That's why tonight, all the women, you know who I am. I've arrived. You can come to Caroline's next Tuesday, June 13th, and you can have my children, because I intend to start a whole new colony that night. And impregnate them.
Looking to repopulate the
world? We got to start colonizing that night. So I need all the ladies to come out that night and give it to me good, because the seed has to spread, and I'm going to inseminate them like they've never been inseminated before. I promise you that.
Well, I see this young lady here
that's right.
Working very hard on that new gum that she tried before.
He is your savior.
My savior?
Mm-hmm. He's everyone's savior.
Pay attention. She helps
me. I'm going to help him get the women, because I know how good this man is. You have no idea. You have no idea how good he is.
Who is this young lady here?
She's Roxanne.
Roxanne?
She's my mainstay.
Hi.
Hi. where did you two meet? In a malt shop?
He saved me.
He saved you?
Mm-hmm.
She was in the audience.
He gave it to me good.
You know, it's like touch one person. You know what I'm saying?
To share the wealth.
Exactly.
You have no idea.
So you don't mind sharing Tommy with
Not
other
at
women?
All. Because his ideas are good. You have no idea. You don't know.
I didn't come here tonight to play around. Tonight.
Oh, so it's not like.
See, I knew I was meant to lead. I knew I was different from the other children, even at a young age, at the age of 8.
Mm-hmm.
At the age of 8, you know.
Well, you can keep talking. All right. Just take.
No,
off
but
camera.
It's part of the. See, that was to throw me off.
Exactly.
What's going on here. You think you're fooling me? Watch your back. I know where you're going. That's okay. Don't worry. I got my back. Okay.
I know.
I didn't come here by myself. Trust me. There were people outside. All right. Play games.
I hope you're not downstairs.
Play games,
well, I know
Mike.
We're going to have to take a break.
How convenient.
Break?
Coming up to 15 seconds.
We got about 15 seconds. I know you think it's a government plot, but we have to take a break in this show every now and then. Because, you know, we have to give our graphic artists a little bit of work.
You're going to deal with this?
You know? You can hold on for a little while, can't you? Stick around with us.
You just wait.
We're going to be right back after the short break. Don't go anywhere. Serious stuff is abounding. Well, we're back, and Tom, I have to apologize. We're probably going to have to go to at least one more break later on. So I hope it doesn't interrupt.
What are they doing on these breaks?
But I'm sure if I was Jay Leno, you wouldn't be breaking so much. Okay,
mm-hmm.
I see the double standard. Okay, because I'm not your puppet. Okay.
That's why there are going to be new children born, because somebody else will be sitting here taking your place with his views distilled in their heads.
How do you know I'm not on his side? And I'm just not a victim like he is of
Do you know what the government's doing? The powers that be. You know the powers that be attempted to prevent me from coming here tonight? The powers that be, they attempted, while I'm with my woman, they attempted to barricade me in my car on a wall of flames. But you know what? I'm still here because they can't stop me. They can only hope to contain
me. He's unstoppable.
That's right. You know why? You know why I'm still here? Because I'm flame retardant. That's why.
It's amazing.
Thank you.
So, you've espoused like a, you know.
Let me tell you something. I'll tell you about espousing. What does the government do to protect the endangered species like the spotted owl? Not a damn thing. We got to help the spotted owl repopulate. You know why? Because they're delicious. That's why. Their skin's so tender, it's like baby seal.
You ever had one?
No.
Okay. So then there are no more breaks. There will be no commercial breaks. It's done. All right? We're taking over this show. Okay? I'm telling you right now. You go along. You do what you're told, and you'll be all right.
You better watch this man. He's like the David Knish.
I feel like a Knish with these lights on me here. To be honest with you.
Yeah, and those lights a little beaming on me a little too much, don't you think? Don't you think? A little too much.
Well, you are kind of fair-skinned, so.
All right, listen.
What was that supposed to mean?
Yeah, like
you could burn easily. I mean, it's like with me. I'm fair-skinned.
He could burn. He just told you he's flame retardant. What are you talking about? He can burn easily.
Let me tell you something. Watch yourself. This is not a game. I didn't come here to play around. You know, in this country, that you could test positive. You know these false positives when it comes to drug testing? Did you know that?
Uh-huh.
Did you know that you could test positive for cocaine just from smoking crack?
Mm-hmm.
And they tell you that flying an airplane is safer than driving a car. Then how the hell am I supposed to get to the airport?
Mm-hmm.
Huh? And they say Snapple that I'm drinking, right? They say it's nature's best stuff. Well, I always thought it was Rohypnol. Now, let me tell you something. I'd like to see you get a girl in bed with Snapple.
You can get a girl in bed with anyone.
We're not playing. This is the new nation, the new regime. We have to start colonizing. You come out Tuesday, June 13th, 9:30.
Caroline's.
Bring it to me.
Are you Caroline's? Listening to him? This
Bring
man.
Bring it to me.
He knows what he's doing.
My loins are hot for you.
I'll help you get there. You come see me.
And ladies, I have opium. Not for me, but for the ladies in the audience. Because I don't do drugs. I do women on opium. Thank you. I wrote that.
So what else do you feel the government is interfering with? I mean,
everything.
Television shows, newspapers,
yeah. Okay.
You know.
Yeah. Children's workshops programs created by pedophiles.
Who?
Pedophile.
Oh, I thought you were talking about me for a minute. I'm sorry.
What I tell you, that was the final warning for you. Now, absolutely, children program, right? We have to give our kids away because they don't behave. Tell her what we did to our kids.
My child's just born, a couple of months. You think I'm going to deal with this child? I'm feeding him his applesauce, he doesn't even eat it, turns his head? I'm not dealing with that crap.
That's why we have to start
Rebellious
over.
Rebellious children,
and
get out
she's got
of
good
here.
Child-rearing hips. Anyway, so what I was saying is this. Basically, look, take the Pokemon, right? What is that translated in English, baby? Pocket monster, right? Let me tell you something, Mike Pettersson, pedophile, whatever you want to call yourself. I'd like to see you make an offer in the playground to a little girl. See if you don't land in jail. And I don't care if you got a Pikachu in your pants.
Or a Chalupa.
New Toy Story movie. What's that about? What's everyone after? Andy's Little Woody.
Mm-hmm.
And that Barney show, that sick Barney show, what is every kid on that show playing with? A bald, purple-headed monster.
Mm-hmm.
Right? And if you think I'm making this up, Mike, I'm not. What are the other sick fantasy characters on that show? BJ? And Baby Bop.
It's right there in front of you. He's just here to tell you like it is. He's here to bring it out and show the world.
Well, this is a public access show, and we try to serve the public so that we bring in dissenting viewpoints, you know? But, you know, I'm trying to figure out, you know, are you, watch the government, but do you feel more towards, you know, the left side politically? Do you bend more to the right side politically, you know?
I'm like a fuselage without the wings.
Just a long phallic symbol, basically.
Mike, let me tell you something.
I can understand that. You want to spread your word?
Listen, I come night after night. I risk my life night after night, going to venue, okay? Touching people's lives, making them wake up and see the light, okay? Call me what you want, but I make a difference, okay? And these people no longer are able to tolerate the ignorance of their coworkers. So instead of telling their coworkers to shut up because they're a blabbermouth, they instead now they tell them they're loquacious. Because by the time they look it up in the dictionary, they now have 20 minutes of peace and quiet.
But are you going to take who are you going to take this out on Tuesday?
Listen, do you have any? My
question.
I don't care about your
question. My question to you is that you're going to have other people there, and you've obviously got to have somebody staked out that you're going to let them know Tuesday that they're on the wrong side of this whole issue.
If you heard in full what this man has to say, you will understand that his views get across to those out there. You people need to listen. All you do is listen. His ideas are good. You don't understand. He's so sincere in what he's saying.
Oh, I understand. He's sincere.
So don't you agree with him?
I am not disagreeing. What I said was that on Wednesday night, we're going to have some violence. And I'm trying to find out.
We're starting at the... Listen.
Who
are
these people we're starting this violence against? Who are they? Who's going to be there that you're looking at, that you're looking specifically to get your hands on Tuesday night?
Why is he yelling at you?
Mike, I don't think you appreciate...
Because this is a hot-button issue.
I don't think you...
And I think everybody should be...
I don't think you appreciate what I risked coming here tonight. Do you know the authorities pulled me over on my way here? Do you have any idea, Mike? The authorities pulled me over. Why? For going through a red light, that's why. And this officer pulls me over. He goes, hey, Tommy, didn't you see the red light? And I said, yeah, I did. You know what the problem is, sir? It was you I didn't see.
There you go.
There you go.
So what I'm going to instruct everyone in the venue is that we should all have sex. And when we do it at our local DMV.
That's right.
Give us a reason to issue us a moving violation.
Well, this is definitely a hot button issue. And we're going to have to come back. What's he doing here? What? We got about 10 seconds or so? Is that what it is? I know. We still got a camera on this young lady over here. Ask the director to please wake up and get the camera off her so that we can have something on. Thank you very much. We're going to be right back after a short break. Don't go anywhere. Got it in. You saw what happened over there, right? It's working its way from the... I'm on your side 100% on this because it's starting in my control room.
Well, then it's...
Baby, was this poisoned?
We got 10 minutes.
They're starting in my control room already.
I don't like the way it smells. I wouldn't drink this crap. He's not one of ours yet.
It's the truth.
It's the Kool-Aid.
It's not Kool-Aid, Snapple.
It's the only stuff that I drink.
You don't know what they put in it to try to change what he's thinking. That's why you're all so messed up.
I can't even read the label without my glasses. What do we got here?
You see how
water?
He's turning the show on
right
to him?
Yes.
We care about his reading.
You're taking it all off us here.
I'm sorry.
Don't waste my time, buddy. I told you, I didn't come alone.
I'm sorry.
This man's very impotent.
I always come alone.
You know, let me tell you something, Mike. You're getting my nerves.
I didn't mean to.
Don't make him mad.
I won't. He's bigger than
me. I won't do anything to you. It won't be me.
You have...
You don't know who we touched.
Where your hands have been?
All right, you have any other questions? Because we got a lot of ground to cover. What do you want to know? The Board of Education sucks. Obviously, if you could be an interviewer, obviously we failed. Obviously.
Well,
you know what?
Look at all the books. Look at all the books we have back here. All right? Look, I'm telling you. Board of Education books, see?
This is exactly what I'm talking about, baby. See, the reasons why our schools suck is because our kids suck.
That's why we need to repopulate the entire world.
That's right. I think all the teachers should have guns. All the teachers should have guns, because kids today, they may not respect an F on their report card, but they'll respect the 38.
I agree with you.
And you know what? If kids are going to carry guns, baby, they should only carry 9mm, because at least that way they'll learn the metric system.
I'll agree.
I'm not playing around here. You know why kids don't do well on exams, Mike? Because they get beat up on the playground. You know why Johnny can't read? Because his eyes are swelled shut. That's why. And let me tell you something. The educational system here is overrated. All the serial killers were scholar students. So you know damn well there was some mother of a C student who told her son, why can't you be more like the Bundy boy?
The parents are sitting there in the classes with the kids anyway.
It's ridiculous. Let me tell you, what about the fire drill, right? The kids are designed to fail. See, I see both sides. That's why I'm like a wing without the fuselage. You see...
Yes,
you have to understand.
Okay.
It's like, look, here's the big, I'm painting a picture.
Okay.
Okay, the fire drill, they tell these kids, walk, don't run. We'd rather have you burn than panic. They say, hey kids, form a single file. Why? Because they want them to form the human wick.
The human wick?
That's right. And what about, last one out, please close the window?
You're a very astute observer
Thank
of these
you.
Things.
Thank you.
I can tell that you know. You're noticing all these little things
I'm
that
public
go right,
enemy number one.
They go right
I'm public
past
enemy number
everybody
one.
Else.
I'm public enemy number
Be
one.
Be afraid.
Be very afraid.
So how many women? I saw there's a bunch of women outside. I mean, are they all waiting for you now?
Yes.
Listen, that's where I come in with the Board of Ed, okay? Being an assistant principal in the schools, I'm able to start with them young. All right? I'm talking about like junior high school here. These 14-year-olds, they come to work. They've got it. You know, and it's my job to mold them into exactly what he's going to want. And that's it.
What age do I like him, baby?
You like him young, honey.
How young?
Very young. As young as you can get him.
The more impressionable, the better.
Mm-hmm.
This way I can mold them. And they wouldn't have to tolerate
they
interviewers
love him.
Like you. You know?
I didn't... what?
You need to get a girl. Okay, that's your problem. I'm going to give you an advice. You want to get a good girl? Go to a Lamaze class. That's where you'll find one. I'll give you even an opening line. Got milk?
Oh,
I don't
okay,
know where I'd
understand.
Be with. I wouldn't know where I'd be without this baby. This baby's behind me all the time from when no one would listen to me.
I love him.
How many women have you found so far to help you, you know...
Well, it's three a day.
Three a day?
Three a day. That's
how many children you want to sire? Is that what it is? You want to sire at least three children a day?
I don't put limitations on myself. I'm better than that.
Okay.
Okay. I will sire as many as I'm capable of in a given day. I don't put the pressure on.
Okay.
I premature ejaculate. And I'm fine with that because I don't buy into the media crap.
Mm-hmm.
Why, I should make love to her for an hour? Why? That's foolish. Why? So I should sweat like a pig? No. No.
Just
no.
Get it over with. Get
right.
The job done.
Get it done. Coitus
yeah.
style.
Yeah. Do you want to, like, you know, have multiple children with the same woman? I mean, or is it going to be totally, let's spread out the gene pool and just, if I have one child with one woman.
Trying to spread out the gene pool, but it can't, you know, doesn't hurt to have
more than one.
More than one, does not hurt.
How many have you had with Tommy so far, or are you just a recent?
After that one rebellious little SOB, that was it, gone. Gone! Can't.
He just wouldn't listen.
I won't tolerate, I, you know.
Just would not listen.
What eventually we'll try again, but right now it was just too much for me. I can't
so
do it.
So now we do it from behind.
Mm-hmm.
Where did this youngster wind up?
I don't know.
You don't know?
For all I care, he's in juvenile detention, for all I know.
It's where he should be.
That lousy kid.
And how old is he?
Couple of months. It's like two months.
I don't keep track of time.
Two months
is universal.
It doesn't start and it doesn't end.
No.
It's just there.
No, but June 13th, Caroline's, the Blue Collar Show. And you know why it's blue collar? Because they're all black and blue. That's why. I am Tommy Savitt. Don't forget that.
I'm not.
They won't forget it.
Ladies, I am your hookup.
I got you. You ever You're all prepared?
This is prime meat. Right prime. Here. Prime.
You got the blue, the blonde, and the build.
And the brains,
D's.
Honey.
And who?
Yes.
And the brains.
Thank you.
But there's nobody that you've got that you're ready. You don't have anybody you're ready to just lash at on Tuesday?
Watch. Come and watch. You will know who's who. Trust me. There will be a price to pay.
That's a good shot, guys. We're talking, and you just got her nodding on camera. You know, you got to keep up with the people that are talking. That's very good.
This is
good.
Part of the
I know.
Crap.
I told
part
you.
Of it, Mike.
I told
Mike, you.
You
said I wouldn't
I
look
told
stupid
you.
Here.
I told you.
You're
I
making
told
an
you.
Ass out of me, and I don't like that.
I think we should leave.
I think we should leave.
I don't know.
I'm out of here, Mike.
I'm following him.
I'm out of here.
What's going
Watch
on?
Watch yourself, buddy.
We're going to be right back after a short break, I hope. That to me all the time, you know, it's not funny anymore. Oh man, what was in here? Make sure you go to Caroline's next Tuesday, June 13th at 9:30. They're right, man, there's something going around here, and I don't know what it is. But Tommy, wherever you are, I know you guys had to leave. Thanks a lot for coming down, and we're gonna make sure we see you next week. You can ask them if they want to. Yeah, I don't know. They're in their own world, and their Thorazine, whatever they're on today, roll credits. Get the crayons out. There's nobody there. They left. I don't know what happened. They're gone. They left. They left me here with the gorilla. I got nothing else. But I want to thank Tommy Savitt and Roxanne for coming down. I'm just... Oh. I don't know if I could take this much more today.